นี่กูดอาฟเทอร์นูนเอฟวรี่วันทูเดย์ไอ้มกอยทูสตาร์ทเซคันด์เซสชั่นฟอร์เซฟทูเดย์วีทอล์กิ่งอะเบาท์นอนลิเนียร์คราคเซคชั่นแอนาลิซิสโอเคso first thing talking about the analysis available in SAFE. So there are the four types, right? Linear analysis is normal. Every time when you apply load, the default will be linear analysis. And the second one, nonlinear, allow uplift. This is for the foundation, for the space footing, the footing without the pie, which is I already explained in previous session. And today I'm going to talk about nonlinear.Crack section analysis, and the last one will be nonlinear crack section with long term. Maybe this one I will explain in maybe next section. Okay. So first of all, I'm going to explain what is the crack section first. So if anyone has some question during my presentation, you can interrupt me any time. Okay. So first of all, we need to understandKnow about the modulus of rupture and cracking moment. Okay, suppose you have a beam or slab. Support apply the load on the beam or slab, right? When you cut small section, maybe in the middle, it's a negative positive moment, right? So from this, when you see the section, the top part will be compression and the bottom part will be tension.As you know, the tension for the concrete has a very poor capacity, right? So there are some limit of tension in concrete. So normally we call modulus of rupture, okay, FR. This one you can calculate from the recommended formula by ACI. This is a formula by ACI, okay? 0.26 multiplied by lambda. Lambda is the factor for lightweight concrete. If you use normal weight concrete, this will be 1.Multiplied by concrete strength, square root of concrete strength. We call the modulus of rupture is a tensile strength for the concrete. Okay. From this, you can calculate the moment. We call the cracking moment. This one calculate from the modulus of rupture multiplied by gross moment of inertia, I gross, divided by the distance from centroid to the extreme tension fiber. Okay, from this is for the positive moment, the form in A to the bottom part at the edge, not at the center of the rebar. We call the cracking moment. Okay. This is a capacity limit for the moment limit.That the concrete can support the tensile force. Okay, from this, next thing we are about the uncracked section and cracked section. Okay, so if you apply if the moment is less than cracking moment, what will happen? There's no tense. The concrete can support tensile force, so there is no crack. So you get the full solid of the section like this in the highlight area like this. So we call IG or mean uncracked. Okay, so I cross like this. We call uncracked section when your apply moment is less than cracking moment. How about if moment your apply moment is more than cracking moment, what will happen? Concrete will crack. Sorry. Okay, concrete will crack. After crack is open, the section of your the beam or slab will be reduced. So.You have a I crack like this, which is less than I cross. Okay. When your tensile state is more than modulus of rupture. Okay. Okay. We call crack section, which is like this. Okay. So next thing we are talking about the curvature that we need to explain in for the cracking. So curvature when you have beam and support by the moment, okay, from the section like this. And when you consider the strain diagram, top will be compression, bottom will be tension. Okay, so you can find the find the strain, and also you can find the C, the distance where the point that your section change from compression to tension. At that point, there is no stress. Strain will be zero. That you can calculate by this formula. Okay, this one is the when you have only the bottom reinforcement. If you have top reinforcement, the formula will be different. You need to check from the RC book design. Okay, from that you can calculate the curvature. Curvature will calculate by the strain divided by this distance. This one like an angle. When you have small angle, tangent of this will be equal to the angle. We call curvature. It's like a deformed shape due to the moment. Deformed shape for the moment, you can have the deflection at up and down. This one is like the leg. They have a rotation. We call the curvature. Okay, this one. And curvature also equal to moment divided by E multiplied by I. It's also the same formula. Okay. So from this, we can plot the moment curvature. It's like a state strain diagram. Or force and displacement. So from this, if support there is no suppose the concrete can support tension, no limit. So you can get the uncracked like this. The curvature will be in this line, and support the concrete cannot support any tensile force. You will get this one fully cracked like this. However, the real one will be in this red line. Okay, so before cracking moment, your deformation or curvature will be on the line of the cracking, like this. Uncracked. After that, it will shift, but it will not shift to the fully cracked. So there are some remain like this. In like red line, okay. So from this, you can calculate. This is based on the formula in the calculation sample calculation for inset. If you align this one, okay, we need to find the curvature on at this point. We call M, okay. So if you realign, it will be like this. So curvature, the point that you want will be equal to curvature crack curvature and plus the difference between uncracked and cracked and interpolate by moment cracking like this. Or if you see the in SCI, they will explain in terms of the moment of inertia. Okay, so you have this moment will be between cracked and uncracked section. So this one will be explained by cracked plus some part of uncracked, which is not full. So some part of uncracked you can interpolate by the ratio between moment cracked and your applied moment. So for the curvature, the power will be 2, and for the moment of inertia, power of for the ratio of cracking moment and applied moment will be 3, like this. Okay. And this one is a step by step for the crack section analysis in SAIL. Okay. There are eight steps. I will explain in step by step in detail. So after finish step 8, SAIL will start step 1 again and do this again and again until the deflection displacement in the last step is small from the previous iteration, like a loop, like a previous step like this. Okay. So first, program SAIL will calculate the moment. So you have the model, you apply the load, and this the first step they will use the uncrack or cross section get the moment okay like this from force apply to the moment. After that program will determine the reinforcement in the section. For the to the reinforcement determine this one can be from three option that you available. So first you can draw the specify rebar, or you can let the program decide based on the moment. Okay, for the second option from finite element based design, or the last one you can have like a we call maybe a typical rebar potential rebar top and bottom. You can apply this also. There's three option. For the first option, you can draw like a, you draw the design strip. Okay? So you can draw and you can specify the rebar size, material property, and left and right area that you want to draw. And also you can specify the vertical offset from datum. Datum mean the top of the slab. For example, this one, the section is about 20 centimeter, okay? And the covering is 4 centimeter. You can see the that. So the vertical offset will be 16 meter and should be in minus because downward. And you can specify number of bar. It's a second step two. And step three, program will calculate the cracking moment based on the modulus of rupture. Okay, you can get the cracking moment, and after that, the cracking moment you can for the modulus of rupture you can specify. There's two options available. One is the program default. This one is based on the design code that you select, or you can specify the value of the modulus of rupture here when you define the material property, okay, from this. So next step, step five. So from this program will plot the curvature for uncracked and curvature for fully cracked. That means no the uncracked, it means the concrete can support tensile for no limit, and uncracked concrete cannot support tensile force like a zero. So after that, program will check the moment, cracking moment, and check the applied moment that we calculate from the step one, and find the curvature at this point. Curvature will calculate from this formula. Okay. And after you get the curvature, you can check what is the stiffness, flexural stiffness, because before we start with fully section, I cross now we call IE I effective, and they use I effective and analyze again, get the deflection. This is will be the real deflection. Before we use I cross, right now we use the I effective. After you get deflection and we have I effective, program will calculate again using I effective, start step one and find the moment. And after that, program will do again from step one to step eight again and again until the deflection from the previous step and the current step is very small, then program will stop. And this one is example from the program from the step from the model. I will okay, and I will share the to the step program. I save. Okay. Go to save and share. Okay, this one. Okay, you can see the program. So from this, I will show you. So if go to define and mental property, and you check the concrete. From this, you can specify the modulus of rupture or tensile concrete strength, right? This one, you can select the program default. This one is based on your select design code. Or you can use the specify, you can put your own. This option, I use the first option, program default based on the design code. Okay. And you can draw the rebar. And after that, you go to run and cracking analysis option. This one, you can define the reinforcement that you want to calculate the crack section. So there are three options. Right? One is you specify rebar. The second one, you form for an element based design. The last one will be kick tension rebar specification. This one like a typical rebar, the last one. So I select the first one, then I need to draw the rebar. You can draw the rebar by use this icon. Okay, draw the rebar. And you can specify the rebar size, rebar diameter, right? Rebar material, and also left line. This lab, this is the one meter length. So I will draw at the middle. So left will be 0.5 or 50 centimeter, right also 0.5. Okay? And datum line, the thickness is 20 centimeter and covering will be 4. So this is for the bottom rebar. The vertical offset will be 20 minus 4, will be equal to 16. And we need to have a minus because it's downward. After that, I specify the number of rebar will be 5. You can draw this down from here to here. So after that, you see the rebar. Okay, like this. After that, I define two case. Analysis case. One case is static due to the lead load, cell weight of this slab. Another one, I select nonlinear crack, and I select the load applied only dead load. Okay, I will run this to and compare. When you see the analysis progress, they will have some iteration. You can see run many times. Until the displacement of the previous and the current step is same or different is very small. Okay. From this, I display the left will be only the dead load, and the right one will be only crack. And you can compare the result. Dead load alone is about 3 millimeter, while the dead crack will be 7.7 millimeter. Okay, like this. And if you want to study in the detail how program calculate the crack, you can. I recommend you go to help and documentation from the list. This. And go to verification and analysis. Okay, and you select the example 16. This one. This is the detail how program calculate, including the long-term crack analysis also. Okay. Okay, that's all about the nonlinear crack section analysis. Anyone has a question? Oh. Oh, crack width, right? Okay. Yes, crack width can. You can show the crack width. I will show you the. Let me share the screen. Share the screen. Yes, program will show the crack width. I haven't prepared the definition. You can show display and also show crack width. You can check from the this one. There are some parameter that you need to study a bit. They show this one, the width of the crack width. Okay. Maybe I will next explain about this crack width maybe in next session. Yes, please ask the question. Right? So I don't know you understand or. Have any question? Or you can send question later to the email or recommend the. Maybe the topic that you want to understand or interested. Okay. So if like this, I will finish this session. Thank you everyone for joy. Okay. Goodbye.